Denzel. Hello everyone, welcome back to Marylena Finds Love, Stories of Deanwood. I am so happy to be here with you today. I hope you all enjoyed episode number one, where I introduced to you who Marylena is, and we walk through her career, her job, and just her plights as a young adult, a young black girl and her braids. Yes, period. Love her braids. And so we're just gonna kind of explore her life and see Wagwan and have some fun with it. So last episode we went to the club, but there was nobody she fancied there. So this episode we're gonna try and bump into people kind of naturally, I guess, and see how that goes. So it is morning time. I am going to turn off the shader. I still haven't found a way to make it less laggy for me. When I do, I will tell you. Of course, I'm going to tell you all, but for now, you'll get the shader in bits and pieces, okay? So we're gonna go to Natura's Farmer's Market. I just built this. I do have a build up, a speed build of me building it. I did make a couple of changes, a couple, nothing crazy, after I found some mods on Tumblr. So Marylena is off to the Farmer's Market.
All right, so we are back from the farmer's market. It's still very early in the morning. She was able to pick up some little bits and bobs, and so we'll go and put those things in the fridge. She got some nice fresh produce. We love a good farmer's market moment. But we also met somebody. We met Mr. Akil Gill, and interesting. I think Marylena has to recover a little bit because she got turned down. But you know what? We're proud of her. We're really proud of her because she knows what she wants and she's willing to go after it and put herself out there, even if that meant kind of embarrassing herself. Kind of embarrassing herself. Okay, so we have some needs to fill. And I think she'll start off by coming home and having a nice cup of tea. She's gonna have some tea. And we're just gonna test to see if the placement of the tea works. If not, I'll be happy to move it, but I hope it does work. Oh, okay, it does. Perfect. So she's gonna have some tea. Perfect. And I'm going to, I think I should move this chair like a bit like here, right? Just to make it look like it's like used, but there's still room because I do want her to sit on this side. So she is having her morning tea and it is boosting up her mood very, very well. After meeting Akil, and he bought her a little bubble tea so she's not super starving. Notice their relationship panel here, Akil Gill, 3 bolts and they have 24. So, just met, I barely know the sim, but if we spend more time together, getting to know each other, we could become good friends. I should pay attention to our conversations and make a plan to get together sometime. Oh my gosh. So yes, she's definitely having a coffee and thinking about the guy she just met, because let's not pretend he's super fine. Super fine. So she's gonna have her morning drinky drink. And I did put a mod in my game for the shivers after they have their coffee to go away. So she's on her way to Maine. She's leaving her apartment right now. So we'll see you all there. So Marylena has arrived at her hair studio. We are here at Maine. It is lovely. So she's just looking outside, making sure everything's good, making sure everything works. And now we're going to head inside. So first things first, of course, we must open up the business bright and early. We also do have a speed controller here, and I'm going to slow, I have it hidden there. We're going to slow the speed to 50% instead of 60. Her mood is great. The store is open. Let's make some money. Let's do some hair. Let's do some makeup. Let's do what we need to do. She's like, I am grinding because we have, not only do we have bills to pay, but also we have a huge fat loan. And so let's greet with a high five, greet with an earthy hug, greet with a kiss kiss. Hello, Christopher. He must have a show. And so most likely, because of that, he is here. And so we're going to just admire him really quickly. Well, hello, hello. Welcome, welcome. Did they become friends? That's really nice. He must be a regular here because he is an actor after all. And so he is going to have to need a lot of touch-ups all the time. So we're going to get him seated, situated, and all the things. Before we even do that, yeah. Let's do that. I was going to say we'll up the prices, but let's keep it moderate for now because Sims will actually want to get the service. So let's start with Christopher. Sorry, the game is a little bit laggy. It will be like that because we just got on the lot. And he loves it. Of course he does. We are a pro and he is a loyal customer. At this point, we've literally become friends. Bye-bye, Christopher. Oh, we have Andrea here. Let's go ahead and greet her with a high five. We'll greet her with a kiss, kiss, darling. You already know. That's Deanwood's pleasantry. Hello. Good morning. Good morning. She's like, I can already see you with like a little bit of a fresh haircut, a little bit of a wash. So we'll do a basic sell as well. And then Andrea's definitely going to want to get a makeover or get a fresh wash. She has blue hair, I guess, so the maintenance for the hair is also, you know, necessary. She's upset with somebody. And we are going to let her get a makeover.
our second customer of the day. I guess if you have blue hair, there's a lot of maintenance that goes into that. So, and Andrea just had a baby. Pretty sure the baby's name is Amelia. And so, of course, you want a bit of a moment to yourself to freshen up a bit, considering you're taking care of a whole child. Perfect. There you go. And voila, you're all ready to go. Give you some fresh layers, a fresh cut. You're good to go. Ooh-wee. Congratulations, your business is now rank 2 and you've gained a point to spend on business perks. Yes, let's look at the perks and what we can do. So we already got the first perk, which was $1,000. I think this one is $10,000. Well done. The rising fame of your establishment has earned you this rebate from your suppliers. We need the money. Y'all already know we need the money. That was, $2,000. Okay, awesome. Awesome. Okay, cool. Andrea, you are done, and she gave us our money as well, so let me just go ahead and make her unselectable. Who else is here? Oh, we have Bryce. She's never met Bryce. We also have Vin. Let's greet Vin first, because she was here first, and it's only fair. So let's go ahead and greet Vin. Sorry, my phone isn't supposed to be on silent, honey. I am recording. So Vin is here, and she's like, I want to spruce up my look, you know. She's like, hey, good morning, happy Thursday. Oh, she paid her a compliment. Lovely. Nice to meet you, Vin. Thank you so much for whatever it is. You seem like a pretty insightful person. I'm developing a new product and I'd be interested. Here's a free sample for you to mess around with. Thank you so much. Look at that. What is the product? I hope it's expensive. Ooh, it looks like a TV. These are the groceries from the farmer's market we didn't put back. Ooh, it looks like a TV. Okay. She gave us a big old TV. And what are we going to do with it? We're going to sell it. And it is, oh my gosh, it's $4,000, you guys. She just gave us $4,000 worth of sample products. And we are going to make profit off of that by selling them in our store, basically. Imagine a distributor gives you $4,000 worth of product to sell at your store for free. You make all that profit. We have $6,790. You guys, look who's here. Look who is freaking here. Okay. We cannot betray Vin. Vin was here first. Let's stay corporate. Let's stay business. Go ahead and you be the stylist. I actually think before you go and be the stylist, let's increase our price. We're at average right now. So she's pretending like she's really busy. Before it was him with the clipboard. Now it's her with the clipboard. Okay, so we're already at expensive. I'm going to make us very expensive because I think we've literally got recognized by a wholesale supplier. Yeah, we're going to step our game up. Okay, we're going to let Marylena be the stylist and Vin here is going to go ahead. Oh, sorry, reset. We're going to let Marylena be the stylist and Vin is going to go ahead and get a makeover. Pro. Why is Jasmine not here? Is Jasmine here today? I mean, usually we say she comes over. Akil, why do you keep resetting? It's weird. Oh my gosh, you look freaking stunning. Beautiful. Yes. $75. Well done. Okay. So it's getting a bit busy. We have Eric in here. We have Levain in here. Lots of hairstyles to do. I'm wondering where... call in employees. Why is Jasmine not here? I mean, we said she's gonna have the afternoon shift, but she should be here. It's 9:45. So let's call in Jasmine and be like, hey girl, you're supposed to be here. Oh, she does not think Bryce is cute. We can't keep ignoring Akil, right? So we are gonna greet him with an earthy hug and with a kiss. She's like, hey, good to see you again after this morning. He's like, oh, you know, I wanted to explore a bit and see what's up. She's like, would you like me to give you a makeover? I don't know if he wants one or not, or if he just came by. Let's see his relationship panel. Oh, 3 bolts and a 51. I think he's gonna tell her a joke. Lighten up the mood a bit. Maybe things are a little awkward after he turned her down. But I think Marylena's also a little bit in the mindset of like, I'm at work. This is my vibe. This is how I grind. Like, you know what I mean? I think Jasmine is here. Is she? Do we see Jasmine? Because it just made us pay somebody. Yeah, Jasmine's right here. Make selectable. Jasmine, I really do want you to earn a badge, and I think it's only fair that she takes some time to at least get a bronze. So you go in the back and continue to study cosmetology. Perfect, perfect. Yeah, so Marylena is definitely, she has a bronze in cosmetology and a bronze in restocking. So she's bronze and she's killing it this way. Imagine when she gets to silver. So she's chatting with Akil, but I think, to be honest, she's kind of like thinking in her mind, like, maybe it's a little more attractive if I'm like in business mode. You know what I mean? Maybe it's a little more attractive if I'm a little bit busy. He was busy this morning, and so it doesn't hurt for me to be busy too. Bryce has been here waiting for a bit, so we are going to have him get his turn and go get a makeover. So she's like, it's so great that you stopped by. I'm really happy about that. And yeah, this morning was definitely interesting. But yeah, I gotta have another client. He's like, oh, okay. I guess I'll just watch you do your thing. Okay, and then I guess Levine will be next. Bryce is getting his locks retwisted, it seems. What do you think about this? Awesome. He loves it. And that's why we raise our prices, because the level of satisfaction is unmatched. Next, we'll have Levine come and do a good job here. Make unselectable, make selectable. And Levine and Marylena, they just went out the other day. I really do think that Levine's husband is throwing her a surprise party. Personally, I think that she's even thinking of getting her hair done and her locks retwisted. Because she's like getting ready for the party, and she has a hint, because Jamie kept calling Marylena, sorry, I don't know if you guys remember that. James kept calling her, and I think she's getting the hint that he's planning a little something. And so she's here to get her hair done, and so we're like, of course, girl, we should have offered it for you. Oh my gosh, I've never seen this in my game before. Do you see this? She literally messed up Levine's hair. I have never seen this before. Oh my gosh, I'm so shocked. Girl, you were doing so good. What happened? She's like, how could you do this? I trusted you to do my looks. That's so horrible. Perfect. Jasmine earned a bronze. Good thing she was in the office and she didn't see her supervisor totally mess up. It seems like Akil wants something done. Oh my gosh, maybe she was just nervous, so she couldn't like focus, I guess. Anyway, we're gonna have her come here. Why can't she come here? You go here. I think she was nervous because Akil was just standing right there. Oh my gosh. Akil was standing right there watching everything, and so she's just like, ugh. She couldn't focus and she didn't do a good job. Ooh, does he make her nervous? Okay, it's his turn. So please don't mess this up, girl. Please, stay focused. It'll be so embarrassing if you messed it up. Go ahead and get a makeover. The Overbur. Okay. She's like, okay, so like a little cut. I can do this. Come on, Marylena, you got this. Please don't mess this up. Please don't mess this up. Come on. Come on, come on. Perfect. There we go. Whew, I was really nervous. I think that'd be really embarrassing. He loves it. Perfect. Awesome. He loves it. So we're really happy about that. And we're gonna make him unselectable. And he's like, oh, I actually have an appointment, so I gotta jet. We are going to greet with a high five, greet with a kiss, kiss, darling. So Jasmine is now on the field, and Marylena is going to take a break and do some work in her office. Jasmine has done enough studying, and so she thinks she's pretty much ready. So Marylena is going to go use the washroom, wash her hands, and then work on an article here, fashion. Jasmine, the floor is yours, honey. Here we go. Let's start with Eric. I see Soleil is here as well, so that's really lovely. And I'm just going to make Eric selectable. She's like, hey, nice to meet you. Thanks for coming by. Appreciate you. And Jasmine is going to go ahead and not use Marylena's chair. I kind of feel like that's the wrong thing to do. So she should use the chair in the back here. And she is going to be offer makeover to Eric. Today's been a busy day, but we definitely made some good money. I want us to get at least one more rank up. It's only noon. We'll close at 5. Girl, be the stylist. Do we need Marylena to assign you again? Assign stylist Jasmine. Perfect. It's like she's glitching or something. So Marylena hears that there's a long lineup and she comes out to service some people. She's not the best, but she does what she can. We've had two failed makeovers, so I'm just hoping that this is not the case for a cat, because I just made her and I like her hair. Why do we keep messing up? What's going on? Okay, you guys, I think today's been a not good day. We're gonna have a lot of Sims looking crazy. I think we're gonna close the business. I think she's just had a long day. I think this morning got in her head and she's just not doing what she needs to do as well as she can do it. I think having Akil come into the store made her a bit nervous, and her contour is just not on point today. You know, it's just been horrible. And so we're gonna close the business, and I think we're gonna just go meet up with one of our friends. Call a sim. We're gonna meet up with Levine. We'll invite her out for some coffee, and I think we also have to apologize for messing up her face. Yeah, Levine right there. Invite over. I think she's right now thinking, like, how could I mess up three people's looks? Like, that's not me. You know, like, I'm better than that. So, yes. Oh, my gosh. I think we're going to fix her look. I think first things first. Let's go ahead and offer free makeover. She's going to be like, girl, I am so sorry. I was just in my head and this new guy came by and I was so nervous. She's like, new guy? This is her friend after all. So I think she'll forgive her. And she's like, perfect. I retwisted your locks and I'm so, so sorry. She's like, of course. What's going on? Why have you been so out of it? This is your craft. This is your element. And Marylena's like, I know. And I just, let me tell you what happened this morning. I met this guy and I don't know, he's just been in my head like all day. Not that I'm talking about Ivy. And she's like, would you like to go for a coffee with me and want to talk about it? She's like, yeah, let's do it. All right. So the ladies have gotten their food and they are now going to sit out here and just kiki and talk a little bit. I think Marylena is definitely going to be like, girl. So Levine's like, so you met somebody? And Marylena's like, I did. I met someone. And yeah, he just has my head a bit frazzled, you know? He just taking up a lot of my time and I don't know. And so I think they're going to talk and she's like, I did meet someone and I can't stop thinking about him, but he didn't want to go out with me and I don't think I'm pretty enough. Deanwood's full of beautiful girls, but I was just really trying to search up the farmer's market because I wanted to bring some treats in. Into work, and then I bumped into him and he was like packing boxes. I don't know if he owns the farmer's market. And she's like, that's a really random way to meet someone, but I kind of like that. It's kind of cute. And then Marylena's like, don't get excited because I've embarrassed myself enough and he wanted absolutely nothing to do with me, but he did buy me a bubble tea. So maybe there's a little hope there. And Marylena's like, girl, maybe bubble tea does mean something. And so I think they're just talking and Marylena's sharing with her woes. I think it's quite embarrassing. Have you all ever been rejected after asking somebody out on a date, a complete stranger at that? I think it is a little bit embarrassing. Although I wouldn't know about that. I don't know about all that. So Levine is having her berry pie and Marylena is finished her cheesecake. This is my coffee shop. I think I've already showed it to you when Eric and his daughter came here. So I do need to add in a coffee machine. I know I don't even have one. So they're chatting and talking. Marylena is quite tired and she wants to take a shower. Anybody interesting that we know here? So she's like, I'm your best friend. You literally messed my hair up today and I forgave you. So I am literally your best friend. But it is getting late and I do have to get home to my husband. She's like, I got you. No problem. So Marylena is just thanking her, like, thank you for taking me out of my mental prison and reminding me that I'm not an ugly rat. I'm a person who is worth love and all the things. So thank you so much. So we're going to have them have a friendly hug. And we're going to have her appreciate her and she's like, thanks so much. And then we'll have her end the casual group. And so they had a really nice pie moment, which was really cute. And she's like, thanks so much for coming and just being there for me. You're genuinely the best friend ever I could ever have, especially after I messed up your hair. She's like, I'll see you later, okay? And she is now going to walk home. Awesome. She's like, thanks for getting us together. Of course. So we're going to head home. Alright, so we are back with Marylena. If y'all remember, she did have to pay her bills and she had like, what, $680 to pay. And of course, we made some money at work. Oh, this is the landlord. Perfect, right on time. So we are going to make sure that she grabs her mail and the paper. Oh, we have Abhijit doing a little bit of a walk by. You can see that the mail is yellow. So that means really they were about to evict us. They're about to turn our power off. So she's feeling a bit tired. That's okay. Go ahead and pay your bills. Perfect. And then we're going to head on into her apartment. So let's go on in and let's fix up these moods as well. She's exhausted. So we're going to have her honestly go straight to sleep and get some rest. Or maybe, yeah, we'll have her go straight to sleep and get some rest. I think that makes sense. And while she is heading to sleep, we're going to talk about her loan a little bit. If you all remember, I showed you she has a loan out. I know. She has a loan out and right here. We have to put the groceries in the fridge. Let's remember to do that tomorrow. She has a loan out in this loan piggy bank. And this is just a CC a mod that I have in my game. And so let's get her loan information up again. You can see that she has $41,500 to pay. We did make we made more than that, right? 7,000 something. She just paid her, there she's going to bed. Night. She just paid her rent. And so we're really going to just push all the rest of it into the loan. So let's pay back. Let's do 5,000. And now let's look at the loan info. Now we have $36,500 to pay off. And I think because she borrowed such a big loan, we're going to reduce the interest rate because she did get that wholesale supplier thing. And I'm just going to think that that means that something changed in her finances. She's able to make a larger payment and they reduce the interest rate. All right. So yeah. We're going to keep the speed on 100 and she's going to go and rest. So that was Marylena's super busy day. And this has been episode 2 of Marylena Finds Love for the Holidays. So we met Akil. Interesting. Very, very interesting. This mystery guy at the farmer's market who then pops up at her hair studio and is like, oh, I wanted to get my hair cut a bit. And I was wondering who owned the studio. And it's you. But they didn't really get to talk properly because the studio was so busy this morning and she was really nervous because she was doing really well up until the point when he got there and was standing right in front of her chair. And then she got super nervous and was like, and started messing up people's contours and their lock retwists, and it was a lot. So we got to think about Levain's advice, right? When they went out for coffee, Levain was like, you know, just because he turned you down once doesn't mean that he doesn't like you or he thinks you're ugly like a rat or something, because he did buy you a bubble tea and he was really kind to you. So you never know. Why not, you know, try talking to him and reaching out a bit. So we'll see what Marylena does. Will she have the guts to reach out? We still have Armando Cox on the line, who was somebody that was interested in her, but he's just a bit of a jerk. but he has been making advances, and they did see each other at the club that time, so he's also on the line as well. I'm really proud of Marylena because she is moving up in business. I'm excited for her to pay off her loan and make more money and just become a household name. Let's work on getting a silver badge for cosmetology as well, because I think that should be her next step. We can't be making these mistakes anymore, y'all. It just can't be happening. And we do really need to think about Jasmine. We've given Jasmine such a big opportunity, basically, to be a paid student, to be an apprentice. All she has to really do is come into work, come on time, go into the office and study, and she gets paid to do that. And Marylena's giving her a huge opportunity, but Jasmine's been joking around a little bit too much. She's not really been too serious. She's been a little flirty with some of the clients. And so we have to consider, is it worth it to have an apprentice who we are paying hourly? Or is she ready to let Jasmine go and maybe bring somebody else on? Or does she need to have a hard conversation with Jasmine? So we'll answer all these questions in the next episode or the next couple episodes. And I'll talk to you all later. Take care. Bye-bye.